Yes, guys, welcome back to the Fantasy Football Fix YouTube channel. My name is FPL Nacho, and in this video, we are going to be discussing the top transfers ahead of game week 3. So if you are new around here, make sure you do hit that subscribe button. And if you do enjoy the content, make sure you do drop a like on the video to share the love. So guys, without further ado, let's get started. Right, so there is no better place to start than the highest scoring player in the game right now in Leeds' Rodrigo. Already had a price rise from 6 million to 6.1 million and been the star man at Leeds. Quite surprisingly, actually, for the folks in the FPL community. Now, he did have a decent preseason, it is worth noting, but at his price point at 6 million to start the season, I think naturally a lot of managers were attracted to the likes of Martinelli, to Bruno at Newcastle, or even the 5.5 options like Neto, all the 5 million options at Leon Bailey. But for those managers that did go early on Rodrigo, then their faith has definitely been repaid over the last two game weeks. 3 goals to his name and an expected goals of 1.44, which, to be honest, looking at it on the face of it, is actually really promising underlying stats. Now, for someone like Rodrigo, naturally with his history in FPL, I think a lot of managers are a bit questionable about whether his form is actually going to be long-term in this Leeds team. But 22 FPL points so far, 15.77 expected FPL points. This is some decent underlying stats, in particular those XG numbers that we are discussing. Now, it's important to note the position that he is playing in this Leeds team. He is very much playing central in that Leeds team. In particular, worth noting, the recent injury to Bamford may change his position in the team, but he has, in those opening two game weeks, been very central. Not necessarily a chance creator in the team. You can see that with the expected assists and the actual output of assists. A bit much more the guys on the end of the balls and actually being the goal getter in this Leeds team. So decent underlying stats. Fixtures are looking okay over the next 5 game weeks. You can see Chelsea at home, not the best time to necessarily bring in Rodrigo into your sides. Brighton away, with the way they started the season, is actually quite a tricky fixture. But then Everton, Brentford and Nottingham Forest, I think, are 3 decent fixtures for somebody like Rodrigo at Leeds. Now, would I be looking to bring in Rodrigo ahead of game week 3? I personally wouldn't. I think with the Chelsea fixture followed by the Brighton away fixture, I think it's another opportunity for us to put him on the watch list and monitor whether the underlying stats are actually going to be sustainable in this Leeds team. Now, if he can post these sorts of goal threat, the expected goals that we are seeing right now, then I think he is going to emerge as a fantastic option in FPL. The one question mark I have right now, first and foremost, is the price point. At 6.1 million, I think naturally a lot of managers are going to find it difficult to go to Rodrigo in their respective teams. A lot of managers might be sat there at 6 million, 6.1 million with Martinelli. Well, I highly recommend not moving from Martinelli right now. He's a fantastic option in that Arsenal team. Then we look at lower price options like Neto or Leon Bailey. And if you do have them funds available to you, then yes, that could be a move that you could go up from that price point into Rodrigo. But I think with the opening two fixtures coming up, it is definitely the right move to sit back, see how he does perform in those two fixtures, and in particular how Leeds get on with the absence of Bamford potentially. And if we do see an asset emerge, then we can look at Rodrigo as a potential 6.1 million option in our midfield. Now, it's worth noting some managers discuss Harrison as a bit of a differential in this Leeds team. But looking at the underlying stats, I don't necessarily see much potential right now as a goal scoring midfielder. 0 shots, 0 XG, 0 goals. He has picked up 2 assists and a 0.98 expected assist, which is worth noting. A bit different to Rodrigo, a bit more of a chance creator in the team rather than actual chance converter in Rodrigo. So if I was picking one or the other, Rodrigo would be my tip right now in that Leeds team. But for me, it's going to be a wait and see on Rodrigo. Let him ride out the next two fixtures and then we can see whether he is a viable asset in the coming game weeks. But again, guys, let me know in the comments, are you owning Rodrigo ahead of game week 3 or have you had him already in game week 1? And if so, you've had a fantastic start to the season. So Rodrigo for me is a wait and see. Let's look at another player who is cheaper, but definitely in and amongst those big transfers in ahead of game week 3. So that man is going to be Brentford's De Silva. Had a price rise similar to Rodrigo, now 4.6 million. Now at the start of the season, a lot of us were discussing who the best 4.5 million midfielder was. The likes of Pereira at Fulham, But De Silva has been the standout option so far this season, and quite surprisingly, actually, considering he's only played just over 90 minutes in those two game weeks, a sub in game week one and a starter in game week two, coming off around the 65-minute point. But again, with them being 4-0 up, that probably was just to maintain those minutes with him being such a long-term injury last season. Now, you can see here with the underlying stats, whereas Rodrigo actually was delivering quite well on his underlying stats, there is quite a big discrepancy between the actual FPL points of 14 and the expected FPL points of 5.64, which I think is worth noting if you are in the market for De Silva. We saw that goal against Man United with De Gea's howler. It is worth noting that he isn't going to be scoring those week in, week out. Hopefully goalkeepers actually make those saves. But two goals and a 0.39 expected goals is where I'm a little bit worried about when managers are planning on bringing in De Silva. I think the expectation right now is that we have to remember that he is a 4.6 million midfielder. He's scored in each game week so far this season, but I really don't see with these underlying stats that being a sustainable output over the coming game weeks. Now, it's worth noting with the opening game weeks coming up, Fulham, Everton, Palace, Leeds and Southampton are fantastic fixtures for De Silva. And I think if you're in the market for a 4.5 million midfielder and have realistic expectations of him, then I think he is a good transfer for you. And I've seen a lot of managers right now go from Neto down to De Silva, look from going from Leon Bailey to De Silva to free up some funds in the bank. And I think De Silva is exactly that if you are in the market for a transfer. I wouldn't be looking to move Neto down to De Silva or Bailey down to De Silva unless you are looking to free up funds to invest elsewhere in your team. And the other question mark that I do have right now about De Silva is the new signings that they have made. They've brought in another Denmark international that can operate in that centre attacking midfield role. And I do question whether that is going to hinder De Silva's minutes. Yes, he might start in the team, but is he going to be a regular 60-minute substitution in that team? And if that is the situation, maybe we do question whether he is a viable option in our teams. So I think De Silva, fantastic option if you are in the market for a player who is in a good team right now with fantastic fixtures emerging. I wouldn't be looking to bring him in if you're anticipating to start him week in, week out and replace him as a player like Neto or Bailey because you want the expected minutes. De Silva, for me, is a player that you're going to bring in to free up funds elsewhere in your team to invest to improve your starting 11. De Silva is a fantastic 12th man in your squads if you are looking exactly for that. But again, guys, let me know in the comments, did you start the season off with De Silva or are you in the market for him right now? I know there's a lot of transfers going into him ahead of game week 3. So that's De Silva covered. We've covered two midfielders. We have a third one that I want to look at now. Now, this man is probably the most exciting for me right now, and that is Pascal Gross. A player that has been in the Premier League for quite a while now, but never ever been an FPL option that we can consider. 5.6 million, another player that has already had a price rise from 5.5 million. And somebody who has really, really been exciting on the underlying stats department. 18 FPL points so far, but an expected FPL points of 18.07. So whereas we look at De Silva and there is a massive discrepancy between his expected FPL points and his actual FPL points, we're seeing a player here that is exactly on par with his actual output, which is really exciting to see. Two goals and expected goals of 1.76. Really, really good to see. Again, not a massive difference between the two. And again, similar to Rodrigo, not necessarily a chance creator so far in the opening two game weeks, but much more an actual goal scorer in the team. And again, goals mean points in FPL. And importantly, you want to be targeting those players that are actually converting those opportunities. So the underlying stats are fantastic for Pascal Gross. And what I love as well when we are looking at FPL options is how the actual team is performing. Players like, for example, Rafinha last season was an example of an extraordinary player playing in a really poorly performing team in Leeds. And that was very much the talisman theory. With Pascal Gross right now, he's got fantastic underlying stats and he's playing in a very, very well-oiled Brighton team who right now have started the season very, very strongly. Brighton can be a bit of a frustrating team. They do come in their purple patches. And sometimes it is the opportunity to pounce on them when they are in these really purple patches. Another brilliant game against Newcastle. And you can see with the fixtures coming up, West Ham, Leeds, Fulham, Leicester and Bournemouth. I only see positive results continuing for Brighton. Now, I looked at the average position for Gross over the last two game weeks, and they are incredibly positive to be seen. He isn't necessarily operating on each of the flanks. He's very much playing almost alongside Welbeck in a front two. Now, while the lineups don't necessarily suggest that, I can tell you now that when we look at the average maps, he is definitely right up there alongside Welbeck. So really interestingly, almost like a second forward at times in that Brighton formation. So the underlying stats are fantastic. The fixtures are great. I think the big thing is, have you got a room in your team for him? Now, I think a lot of managers here right now are sat there with Neto in their team or Leon Bailey. And if you have a bit of money in the bank, then the Bailey to gross option is available to you. And naturally, if you have Neto and a little bit of cash, you can do that sideways move to Pascal Gross. Now, I think right now, some managers that roll their free transfers probably do have two free transfers in the bank. And I don't think you could do much worse than bringing in Pascal Gross into your team. Based on predicted points, he's actually the fourth best predicted points over the next five game weeks on midfielders 6 million and below. Now, there are a few surprising picks in there above him, like Rodri at Man City. But again, with Pascal Gross, we're working off a very short-term sample size. And if he does maintain these sort of underlying stats, then I'm really interested to see if he does emerge as a player that we have completely overlooked over pre-season and someone that we really are going to miss the boat on if we don't move early. Now, with West Ham away, although I think Brighton could do definitely a job on them, I think that could be, if you want to wait one more game week, the opportunity to put him on your watch list and see how he does operate in the Brighton team against a tricky opposition like West Ham. And if he does pass the eye test again and the underlying stats are strong, then we could look to maybe move in for these fantastic four fixtures after West Ham away. So while I think Rodrigo is a wait and see, and I think Da Silva is an option that you can use to utilise funds in your team to invest elsewhere, I think Pascal Gross is a brilliant option for you to consider in your teams now if you want to move. I like the sideways move from Neto to Gross and equally the upwards move from Leon Bailey to Pascal Gross. One move I definitely wouldn't consider is the likes of Martinelli down to Pascal Gross. Again, we are working off a very small sample size, but I really do like what I am seeing with Pascal Gross there. So let me know in the comments, guys, what are your thoughts right now? Which of these three players are you targeting in your teams, or are they all a complete avoid? I'm really interested to hear what your thoughts are in the comments, guys. So that is going to wrap up the top transfers videos for game week 3. I really hope you enjoyed this video. And again, if you are new around here and enjoyed the content, make sure you do hit that subscribe button. And if you enjoyed this particular video, make sure you do hit that like. It'll be massively appreciated. So guys, we will see you in the next video. Take care. Cheers.